couple of minutes for other people to join and then start. Can you hear the music in the background as well? Great. Good. Thank you for letting me know. Awesome. All right, so let's begin. Welcome everyone to Body Balance. And thank you for joining me this morning and for the time that you're gonna spend watching the class for the next maybe 45, 50 minutes. So for those of you joining me for the first time, all you need to know is Body Balance is a mix of Tai Chi, yoga and Pilates moves and poses that are designed together with the music to increase your body strength, activate your glutes, hamstrings, obliques. We target the core, the abdominal muscles, we target the back muscles also, and we then at the end of the class go into a stretching sequence to help you feel re-energized and ready to get on with your day. So body balance increases also your concentration, your coordination, challenges your balance, puts your mind to work, because you have to follow along the sequence that you see and that I teach you at the beginning. So it's really a complete mindfulness and a great body mind connection. So remember, we are all in different stages in the journey, in the fitness journey. So even though some poses might seem easy, or you know, the movements are very slow, they can be very intense. So whenever you feel like taking a break or you need to release a pose or stretch, do so at any time and do what is safe for you. Today we're going to be focusing on our hamstrings and stretching a bit and lengthening those muscles that sometimes can be a bit tight in most of us. So then also try to listen to your body and ease into the stretch or into the movement with care, and just do it very gently with your muscles, because sometimes they're really tight in for some of us. Hi, Dulcie, Lucy, hello everyone, thank you for joining me. Great, so we're just gonna begin, and I'm gonna run you through some of the moves in the Tai Chi warm-up so that you know the basics. So come up to the mat with me before we begin. Let me just show you what we normally do in the Tai Chi. So we stand with our feet wide apart. Toes are pointing towards the corners of the room. Your knees are pushed out as well towards your baby toes. And we go into like deep squat or a sumo squat. This allows us to, you know, flex our knees and move from side to side easily. We also, in Tai Chi, tuck our tailbone just to allow that nice long length in the spine from the tailbone to the top of the head. So tuck your tailbone in, squeeze your glutes and activate your quads and your hamstrings. So in this sequence, all you need to know, there's a move for the hamstring that's going to be quite of a dynamic stretching. So I'm going to show it to you. We go into a squat and the move is just picking up some air, going into a prayer, and then we shift the weight to one side and extend one hand and one leg, bending the other one, and then we move the hip back and we switch sides. So go into the squat and then stretch. This lengthens your hamstring. So make sure that when you transition to the squat, you do it very gently. Right, let's begin with our first track. Right, so go into your Tai Chi stand and start bringing some air to your chest and releasing. Deep breath. Let's increase the range of movement. Stand. Lower to the center. Draw your elbows in and push out. All very slowly. Deep breath. Extend. And elbows in. Push out. Great, one more time. Exhale, elbows in and extend. Pick up some breath. Remember your shoulders are really relaxed and away from your ears. Core is engaged and you're always breathing. Great. Let's now release, and we're gonna go into some circles, very gently, all the way up, and we stop and pause. Come back again to your circles, soft arms. Concentrate on your arms, your movement, and the softness of your upper body. Feel how your spine starts just mobilizing and feeling free. One more time on this side. And come back to the center. Let's go to the other side. And soft arms. Squat, stretch, and squat. Remember, your legs are at this point making a lot of effort, and you're not even knowing it. Great. Just give me a couple more circles. Inhale, big circle, and exhale to pause. Great. Let's go back to the center, and then let's just circle from one side to the other, very gently and slowly. Sweeping with your underhand, and circling slowly as the whole body rotates from one side to the other. Lovely. Now get ready to go into your hamstring stretch. So now we pick up some air, go into your prayer and extend. Hold it there. And squat back down. Inhale. And squat down. Inhale. Exhale to hold your pose. Squat down. Great leg work. Beautiful move. Is your mind controlling? How slowly can you go? Beautiful. Let's do a couple more just to get the best out of this warm up. And last one. Great. Let's go back to our initial move. Elbows in and push out. Great. Deep inhale. Be generous with your breath. Feel your lungs with all the energy today. One last time. And release. Stretch your legs. Just extend them. Start walking back with your legs. And give them a good shake. Perfect. Right, so now we're gonna move into our yoga salutations. So drink some water if you need to, take a break, and then I'm gonna show you the sequence so that you can memorize it, know what the moves are, and then we'll start the track together. So today we are going to also include a move called pyramid, which is stretching both legs. So again, be gentle when you stretch out and do you ease into that stretch. Right, so our sequence is gonna start with our hands clasped behind. We open the chest. Make sure you're standing with your feet parallel to each other, hip distance apart, knees and ankles are under your hips, and your shoulders are squared and facing forward. Your neck is really relaxed and shoulders are rolled down. So we clasped our hands behind. Push the pelvis forward to get a nice good stretch here. And then we go into a fold slowly. And from there, we go into a downward dog. Downward dog, from here, stretch. Now, go into a lunge. So leg between your legs, your hands, and then easy and gently stretch into your pyramid. You might need to put the heel down, or you might just do a little stretch with your knee. Remember, different levels for everyone. Just be safe. So we go into a lunge, we go back into downward dog, other leg goes forward, go into pyramid, lunge back up, again downward dog, and here, knee to chest, kick out to three-legged dog, two times with each leg, and then from here we roll into our crocodile, strong arms, and slowly come down into crocodile, and from here, baby cobra, hold a stretch, go back into your downward dog, and then both legs together. And we come up, and that's the sequence. Great, so let's do it with the music. Together, remember your pyramid stretch, just make sure you're very gentle on that stretch. Great. Let's begin. Hands clasped behind your back. Open the chest. Inhale, fold, and go into downward dog. Lunge, chest up. Stretch into pyramid. Lunge one more time. Back into downward dog. Other leg, pyramid, lunge, back into downward dog, kick into the chest, and out, in, and out, leg down, other leg, come on, some good energy here, feeling strong, great. Lunge back and feet together. And that's our sequence. Let's do it again. Hands clasped behind. Extend your chest. Fold forward into downward dog. Lunge between your legs. Pyramid. Slowly back to lunge, and downward dog. Other leg, lunge, gently into pyramid, lunge. Downward dog, kick in, one, two, switch legs, strong arms there, core engaged, and land down, transition into your crocodile, slowly bend arms, and baby cobra. Beautiful, downward dog, both legs together, and release. Beautiful, one more time, clasp your hands behind, fold forward, downward dog, into lunge, gently stretch the pyramid, lunge, downward dog. On the leg, gently stretch, lunge, downward dog, kick in and out, in and out. Other leg, activating your core. Get ready to go into downward dog and roll forward into your crocodile. Strong arms and baby cobra. Beautiful. And that's it. We're finished, guys. Very good. Good. Roll back up and take a break. Just shake your legs. You need to drink some water, then just take deep breaths until we calm down. Great. Morning, Ellie and Lucy, they have who joined us at the end. Great that you're doing this with me. Should be feeling your heart rate going up, strong legs, the body is pretty warm now. Your arms, your core is already activated, so good work. Right, we're gonna move into our standing strength poses. So again, remember, some of the poses are intense, so release the muscles and take a break whenever you need to. Also, we will be doing triangles and stretch triangles like this. Most of the time, remember, you don't need to stretch the whole leg. You can do a gentle, you can bend your leg or your knee slightly if you need to. Great. So, yeah, that was hard. good, let's begin with the next track, which is our standing strength. Right, so coming up into your warrior two. So heel aligned with your bum, extended back leg. This is your strong leg that's going to be holding all your weight and doing most of the work. Squeeze the glute, and then if you can, straight and stretch the leg in front. Go into an extended triangle and then just start moving your waist forward. And then come down slowly, reach for your leg. Remember, you can have it slightly bend. And try to open the chest and then just give me one circle with the hand, extend, beautiful. Bend the leg, place your elbow on your leg and extend. And make sure you make a long line with your toe on your fingertips, your heel on your fingertips. Beautiful. Slowly rise up into Sun Warrior. Feel that beautiful stretch. I've got one last challenge there. Stretch the other arm if you can and just hold it there. Squeeze the glutes. Oh, beautiful. And slowly release your pose. Let's switch sides. Move your heels, reset your pelvis, and your shoulders are squared, looking forward. Extend your warrior and go into a triangle. Come on down to your leg and open the chest. Give me one circle. Great. Bend the knee forward, place your elbow, and go into a long straight line from heel to fingertips. Hold it there, and now slowly and gently start going to your warrior two, Sun Warrior. Stretch. Lift to the front, face forward, and lift that other arm. Feeling the beautiful stretch. Lovely. And release. Wow, great. Legs together into a squat position. Go into your squat position and then try to come to your toes. If you can, and lower your hips and gently go up. Still standing on your toes. Bit of a balance challenge here. Make sure your core is engaged. Glutes are really active and contracted. And you're keeping your balance. Beautiful, stretch. One more time, come down to your heels and open and stretch up. Feeling that nice length of your spine and slowly release. Great, really good guys. We're gonna go into our core track, so I'm just going to angle the camera a little bit better here so you can see me working down on the mat. We're gonna do a bit different this time. Let me just hold this. We are gonna start activating the core with some planks. So come down on all fours and then go into your downward dog pose, stretching. Make sure your shoulders are aligned. We're going to be doing this movement. So when you come down, when you push forward, your elbows and your wrists are right under your shoulders. So make sure you set up there on the mat before we begin. I'm just going to open a little bit, make it a bit lighter. Great. Ready? So let's begin. Going to downward dog first. 10 toes and heels are hip distance apart. Bend the knees and push forward into a plank. Inhale. Down and exhale to come to plank. Make sure your scapulas are rolled down, your shoulder blades are rolled down. You're keeping a nice flat back and your core and glutes are engaged. Beautiful fluid movement. Just four more. Use your breath. last one, hold it. And pop your knees on the mat and stretch into your child's pose. Great. Beautiful work. Now from here, go down on your elbows and on your palms into a plank. Great. And then we're just going to lift and lower the hips. Make sure that core is engaged. You can feel how the core and the back muscles start working to keep you stable. Great. Breathe. Inhale. Exhale. Exhale as you go into the plank. Four more, guys. Three, two, one. And pop your knees on the mat and go into your child pose stretch. Good. Bet you're feeling the core now. One more in this position. One more challenge in this position. Go onto all fours. Checking your setup. Hips and knees are aligned. And then gently lift knees from the mat. Lift them off. And you can hold it there. Or you could just give me a couple of leg kicks. Three more. Engage the core. Keep shoulders and pelvis still, hold it, and come back. Take a break there. And when you're ready, come back off, knees off the mat, and stretch. Let's go for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, two, one, hold it, and release. Great, back into your child's pose. Just stretching those back muscles and breathing deeply. Shift your legs forward. We're going to go into a bit of abdominal activation here. So your options are either to go on your shoulder, on your elbows. This is your safe option as you lift and bend both legs. You can also go down on your hands, if this is maybe easier for you. You should feel both the lower abdominals working and the leg muscle engaged. Or your advanced option is just hold your legs and just balance on your sit bones. I think we've done this before. So whatever it's easier, you can just give it a little raise or stretch all the way up, whatever your level, right? So let's begin that sequence. Whatever the option you chose, on elbows, on your hands, or going all the way to your sit bones. Let's do 6. Come on. 5. Engage the core or go back. Go back to a safe option. Just keep on moving. Last one. Hold it. Hold it. Breathe. And gently release. Great. Go back down. onto the mat. Release the tension in the shoulders, head on the floor, and give me some simple leg stretches. Extend and exhale. Lovely. Progression from there. If you want to make it harder, lift your shoulders, your chest, and head off the mat, keeping the head on the chin level with the floor. Two more on each side. Last one, and knees to chest. Great. Lower down and take a break there. Pull those knees close to your chest just to release any tension. Great. And our last core challenge today is a double stretch. So we go back down on the mat. Your option is to keep the head on the mat if you find it a bit difficult. If not, just lift shoulders and head. And from here, we're going to go into a stretch. Arms and legs at the same time. Very slow control movement, as if you're taking off a top hat and circle all the way down. Inhale here and exhale. And come back into your inhale. Deep breath and exhale. Right, only five of these circles and double stretches. Inhale and exhale. Strong core. Four more. Lovely. Three. Stretch. And come back in. Last two. Great. And the last one. And we're going to hold it here for four. Three. Two. One, and circle back, knees to chest, head on the mat, and enjoy that nice stretch. Lovely. Great. When you're ready, come back up, and let's do some back exercises just to balance our core muscles. So come on all fours. When you're ready, knees under hips and shoulders, sorry, elbows under your shoulders. Just go into a couple of cat stretches, gently uncurling and curling the back. As you curl in, look down to your toes and slowly uncurl the back. Just two of these. Feel your navel drawn in when you start curling. Lift it towards your spine. Stretch and release. Great. From here, we're going to go into a pointer. So lift your leg and then lift opposite arm. Bring chest, knee and elbow together to the chest and extend. Keeping everything very stable. Your hips and shoulders are level with the floor. Three more here. Slow core activation and stretch. Keeping that nice long line with your body. Let's do the other side. Lift one leg. Lift the opposite arm, extend first, and then come back in knee and elbow together, extend. Knee, elbow together and extend. Focus on your long line on your body. Rather than lifting, you're extending, trying to touch the opposite wall with your toes and your fingers. Last one. Extend and release. Beautiful. Great. Just go down on your child's pose stretch. Take deep breaths. And calm yourself down. Beautiful. From here, we're going to go into our inverted plank. So make sure that your fingers are facing the side of the mat or to the side, whatever is comfortable for you. Just don't over, you know, don't send the hand too far away from your body, just to protect your shoulder joint. So from here, both legs are together. Inhale, lift your chin, lift your chest, and give me a good lift of the hips and extend. Hold your breath there, engage the glutes, look up to the ceiling, and hold that position, not letting the hips drop. Legs are really, really engaged and tense. They're together, and release your pose. Come back up. Again, sit upright. Put the music here one more time. Get set to lift the hips and exhale, go. Beautiful. If it feels safe, you can start looking a little bit further back to the ceiling, but just focus on keeping your hips and your glutes engaged and release. Great. Last one, and in this one, we're going to do a bit of leg raises here. So get ready to inhale and exhale as you lift. Strong arms, strong core, engage. Just give me three leg raises. One. Don't let your hips drop. That one's tough. And release. Go down slowly. Straight back. Hands. Legs are together. We've got the other side to go. So get ready. Inhale and exhale one more time to lift. Set up to lift your leg. It's a very slow, controlled move. And that's what makes it worse. Beautiful. Come back down and release. Lovely. Straight back. Good job, guys. Awesome. Bend your knees here. Hold your ankles gently. And let's start stretching our back. What I need you to try to think of is keeping that long back straight. So don't curl, just extend it. And see how you can slowly release the hamstrings and straighten the legs, or you can just keep them bent. Either way is a great stretch. Hold it there. Beautiful. Now I've got one challenge. Opposite arm, opposite leg. Hold it. Hand behind. See how far you can come up. Think of straight lines with your body. Arms, legs. You can bend the knee if that feels better. Listen to your body, what you can do today. Slowly bend the knee and release. Grab the other ankle. Set your lower, your back arm. And lengthen. Chest up, proud. Feeling that lovely stretch down your hamstrings. And release. Great. From here, your fingers are facing towards your toe. And we come up. Just hold your glutes there and start giving me a couple of lift with your hips. Don't lock your elbows, just to be sure you're not hurting your joints. See, this is a version of your bridge, but just working a bit more on your arms. Lovely, and slowly release back into your straight legs. And that's it, guys. That's the end of our workout. Just want to go into our stretching session now. Just make sure that we release most of the muscles that we worked on today. So come into your mermaid pose. We're going to stretch our back, so make sure you've got 90 degrees here with your leg and 90 degrees here with this leg. Open your arms to the side and inhale, come to the center and stretch out to one side and feel that lovely mobility and flexibility going through your spine. Come back to center. Inhale and exhale one more time to the same side. Come back to center. And now we're going to go to the opposite side. Inhale and exhale. Beautiful time, and exhale. Great. Switch legs. Shuffle them to the other side. Do your setup. 90 degrees, 90 degrees, if that's fine. If you struggle to find this position, you could just sit with your legs together like this and stretch. So inhale on one side and let's stretch. You can walk out with your hand if you want to feel a deeper stretch. Lovely, and gently return to center. One more time. Walk out with your hand, feeling that lovely stretch along your side. Switch legs. Great. No, that's not right. Sorry, we were just doing that the same leg, and we were going to go into the other side. Sorry, guys. Beautiful. Inhale one more time and exhale to stretch. Oh, feels so good down, all the way down from your arms and into your obliques. A bit of hip flexors. Great. And release. Great. Our last stretch is going to be kneeling on the knees. So let's do a simple hip flexor stretch. So from here, tuck your tailbone in, push the pelvis forward. I'm just gonna lower the music a bit. Push the pelvis forward, square hips and shoulders, and then just press down. Lovely. From here, let's do a bit of a hamstring stretch. Heel on the mat and gently with your back straight, see where you can go. You might need to keep that knee bent or stretch. And feel that lovely stretch along the hamstring or the posterior side of the leg. Breathe in and breathe out. As you go deeper, just hold it there for a few seconds and release. Let's switch legs. So you're going to your hip flexor stretch first, feeling that nice long stretch down the hips. You might want to bring your arms out if you need to stretch a bit deeper, and or even take it a bit to the side if that feels right for you. It's all about exploring what your body can do. And now gently, heel on the mat first, Heel on the mat, get a good balance there on your knee. And gently, if you need to bend the knee, do it. And then ease into that stretch, keeping your back straight. Breathe in and breathe out to lower your chest to your knee. Great. A few more seconds here, guys. And release. And that's it. Well done, everybody. Well done, everybody, for just being with me throughout the class. I really enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed it as well. We did a full body workout, especially working on our hamstrings today. Remember to stretch them. They usually get very tight, you know, just from sitting for long periods of time, or just most people have very tight hamstrings. And when you start releasing them, you start feeling that you've got like better posture, or sometimes those back pains might ease, or it just feels a lot better. So great that you are here with me today. I hope to see you next week with more moves and poses. And I'm sending you lots of love and all the positive energy for the rest of your day and the week. Thank you so much, everyone. Goodbye. And thank you for watching. Great. Bye.